until we get it. Come on down, if you're with it. Wake up, let's go, we're on a mission. Recognize we've got that power. And we make sure that you know it. Got that pride, go ahead and show it. Stand up, fight back, no time for hoping. Recognize we got that power. We won't stop until we get it. Come on down, if you're with it. Wake up, let's go, we're on a mission. Recognize we've got that power. And we make sure that you know it. Got that pride, go ahead and show it. Stand up, fight back, no time for hoping. Recognize we got that power.
Now I'm watching the Elife Power Lunch Show. I'm Chris Murray, and I'm here with the great Dr. Baruch.
Hey, Chris.
Hey, it's a special edition.
It's a special edition. We like special editions.
That's right.
Because it's special.
That's right.
That's right. What's up. And today we're going to the island of St. Thomas. And on the island of St. Thomas, we've encountered a basketball team. Not just any basketball team, but the best basketball team on the island of St. Thomas. The girls' basketball team. You tell us what the name is, because I'm going to have to read that.
Yes, the Charlotte Amalie High School.
The Charlotte Amalie
girls
High
basketball
School.
Team.
Chicken Hawks, right? The Hawks.
Yes.
That's what's up. Let's go ahead and expand this view and see who we got in the studio with us.
Yes. Hello.
Good afternoon today.
Good afternoon, family.
Hello. We've got Brother Jelani Horton, coach, representative, team rep.
You know,
okay, all of that.
Yes.
All right. And Sister Rhea Benjamin.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
Great. That's what's up. I good, Mom.
I love it. So tell us, how did you guys find yourself here?
Well, last year we, in an effort to create and explore opportunities for the young girls in the Virgin Islands, we started a foundation called the VA College Prospects Foundation back in St. Thomas. And we did that last year. And we invited teams to come to the islands to play in a tournament called Rock City Jam. And one of the perennial powerhouses in the entire country happens to be right here in Upper Marlboro, in Largo, called Riverdale Baptist High School, the Lady Crusaders.
Uh-huh.
So the Lady Crusaders came down last year with two of their teams. Uh-huh. And we had teams from Canada, Atlanta, Georgia, and Florida. Uh-huh. And they all took part in the Rock City Jam. Cultural basketball showcase. So this year, Riverdale asked us to come up and be part of their She Got Game Classic, which was held this past weekend. Mm-hmm. So we came up to return a favor.
Okay.
And in so doing, we also incorporated a college tour to it.
Mm-hmm.
So we visited Morgan State, University of Maryland, Georgetown University, and Loyola of Maryland.
Okay.
So tomorrow we'll be visiting Howard University, and today we'll finish up with Bowie State.
Okay.
Yeah.
I love it, and I love the way you guys mix the college tour into
yes.
it. I wouldn't have thought of something
yes.
like that.
Yes.
That's incredible. So tell us a little bit more about what you're doing in the community back home.
Well, it's all about empowering our young ones.
Mm-hmm.
I'm currently also teaching history at the high school.
Okay.
And in understanding history, we understand that the lack of information tends to limit our resources and access to them. So our VA College Prospects Foundation, our motto is to, we train for scholarships. And so Rhea is currently a senior at the high school, an honor student.
Okay.
And what? She is going, she is also a three sports athlete.
Yeah.
Softball, volleyball, basketball.
Mm-hmm.
And so everything we do is geared around getting them into college.
Right.
Free education through scholarships and to expose them to the world. We went to the National African American Museum
mm-hmm.
on Monday.
Mm-hmm.
We went to the Black Wax Museum,
okay.
National Greats in Wax yesterday in Baltimore.
Right.
So it's team building, mm-hmm. Organization, leadership skills, life skills, mm-hmm. Nutritional skills, because mm-hmm. you can be as athletic as you want to be.
That's right.
You need to know good nutrition.
How to fuel the body, yes.
And so that's a lot of what we're doing back home.
Okay.
And Rhea is part of that push, mm-hmm. and represents a whole bunch of girls. And it's not, you know, we are coaching. Coach Howard Dorsey and myself coach the girls team at Charlotte Amalie High School. But VI College Prospects is about the Virgin Islands,
okay.
not just one high school or one team.
Right.
It's about all girls.
Right.
So we have a small program called the Little Dribblers,
okay.
and it's co-ed, and we do 6 years old to 10 years old. We have VI Daughters, mm-hmm. which is a program. It's more like, it's called AAU,
okay.
Where we travel in the summer to play in front of college coaches.
Okay.
And then on the high school level, we have the Lady Chicken Hawks. So we have a lot going on, but it's all geared towards building life skills and finding scholarship opportunities for them.
Right, which is really important. I like the involvement. It's just all inclusive.
Yes.
You know, here we have certain programs that do sort of similar things, but mm-hmm. it seems like you've taken a personal initiative, you know, to really make sure that the girls and the other kids, as mentioned with the other organizations, really thriving. It's not just about saying that you want to do something, but you're actually living it and walking it out and make sure that they're achieving the goals that you guys set for them.
Correct. It's very important, especially part of coming at this time was during for the inauguration.
Yes.
So we're still trying to navigate how we will experience the inauguration, because in witnessing some of the campaign rhetoric,
yeah.
and the hostilities at the rallies,
mm-hmm.
We don't think we want to be in that spirit,
mm-hmm.
right.
you know? But so we're still trying to navigate how the children will best experience that, because if they're going to be folks there protesting,
right.
or at least raising concerns,
right.
the alternate views,
mm-hmm.
We want our students to see, mm-hmm. to be able to see that, because when in history are they going to see this again?
Right.
Hopefully not, you know, such polarized views.
Yeah.
So we're still working on how they can experience that and go back home, because when we go back home,
mm-hmm.
they're going to have to present their experiences to the boys team, the junior varsity teams.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're going to have to share their photo albums, explain them, everything they've seen. To help them experience through their eyes,
right.
you know. So,
right.
Harry Belafonte was quoted as saying that too often our young people understand the rights they have,
mm-hmm.
but they don't understand the responsibilities
right.
they have.
Mm. Yeah.
And
yeah.
so, we are trying to expose them in. Magnanimous, positive way.
Right.
That if a residue of it stays with them,
right,
it'll put them in a good place, you
right,
know?
Right, most definitely.
Yeah.
And Rhea, from your experience firsthand, how has being a part of this affected you, impacted your life so far?
First, it affects me because it showed me more leadership.
Okay.
It showed me how to be more responsible and give thanks to my coaches for giving me this first-hand experience with the different museums and the different college tours.
Right.
Stuff like that.
Right, okay. Do you have a favorite college? I know you still have a few more to check out. Do you have a favorite one so far? I don't know if we should say that. Should we say that?
Morgan State. My favorite so far.
So far, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. Do you know where you're going to study yet? Still deciding?
Yeah, still deciding, but I'm mostly looking at schools in Florida.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's probably better climate-wise, right?
Yeah.
In Florida.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Mostly going to study business management.
Okay.
More like on the sports level, because if I don't get to succeed playing it, I could be more around it and managing it.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, and I know you guys were a part of one of the Martin Luther King Jr. Day celebrations on Monday. What was your experience there?
On
Monday?
Monday, yeah, the We Feed Our People event.
Oh, I think it was a very good program or organization to help feed the less fortunate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I was glad to help out with them and, you know, be a part of their life.
Right. Excellent. That's definitely important, and it's just amazing to see that you guys in high school are able to, you know, make a journey that's this huge. And like I said, it's just incredible that not only are you guys, you know, doing what you love, you're getting that cultural exposure. Yes, you're giving helping hand, which is an even greater benefit to it. But you're checking out colleges and you're learning things. You're learning about the political world. Mm-hmm. So it's huge, and I'm glad that you guys were able to stop by and just share your story with us.
Yes. We definitely want to give thanks to you and Elife Media for what you do, because we came here to eat, you know, at Everlasting Life, you know, and then to see the studio was a blessing. And it's important to share the good news that's going on in our lives, in our communities. And, you know, we'll be back, and we'll be sharing more information with you. So we encourage ones to look us up at vicollegeprospects.org. For the basketball team, they can look up facebook.com/CAHS Girls Basketball. So any and every support we can get, resources, books, videos, guest speakers, we take it, you know. And come on down to the Virgin Islands.
Oh, yes, you guys heard that open invitation.
Lovely beaches. right now it's about 82 degrees. With a smile, we have our carnival season coming up in April.
Okay.
St. Croix just finished their carnival season just this Christmas season here. So St. Thomas's carnival season will be in April, and St. John's carnival season will be the 4th of July weekend. So lots to do down there, and lots of food, lots of music. So come on down, you know?
Great. Well, thank you very much for coming on board and being a part of the Elife Media experience. It is it's no small thing to, you know, gather up some young ladies and bring them here to the United States and to expose them to not only sporting but also educational opportunity. You know, so we applaud you, Brother Jelani, for the work that you're doing, and we look forward to staying connected with you so that, you know, like you said, you know, we can bring attention to work that you're doing, and likewise, you all can bring attention to the fact that there are media houses like ours that want to bring attention to positive things that people that look like us are engaged in, right?
Yes.
So,
yes.
Again, we want to thank you, and thank you, Rhea, as well, for being a part of an organization. And, you know we have choices. I remember when I was your age, and, you know, we had choices, and we applaud you for making good choices, and prayerfully, you know, you'll continue on that road as you work to create a future for yourself, because all of these moves and decisions and these connections and these people that you run into here in America, they can all be significant connections, and you don't want to downplay how important that is. So thank you to both of you.
Thank you.
Indeed.
All right.
Chris?
Yes, well, thank you guys for tuning in. If you have questions, feel free to go ahead and ask them. We're going to be posting this, and we always check our posts. So if you were unable to connect with us live, that's okay. You still have another opportunity. If you are in the area and you want to come and hang with us tonight, we are hosting our weekly Health, Wealth, and Knowledge of Self workshop series. We're going to be talking fitness and politics and just family and community as usual. So come on out, 6 p.m., grab a bite to eat. If not, then come out at 7, and that's when the presentation will start. I think that's it for now, guys.
That's it.
So take care, and thank you for watching. This has been the Eat Life Power Lunch Show.
Recognize we've got that power. And we make sure that you know it. Got that pride, go ahead and show it. Stand up, fight back, no time for hoping. Recognize we got that power. Stop until we get it. Come on down, if you win it. Wake up, let's go, we're on a mission. Recognize we got that power. And we make sure that you know it. Got that pride, go ahead and show it. Stand up, fight back, no time for hoping. Recognize we got that power.
till we get it. Come on down, if you wet it. Wake up, let's go, we're on a mission. Recognize we've got that power.
And you make sure that you know it.
Got that pride, go ahead and show it. Stand up, fight back, no time for hoping. Recognize we got that power.
Don't stop until we get it.
Come on down, if you wet it.
Wake up, let's go, we're on a mission.
Recognize we've got that power.
And you make sure that you know it.
Got that pride, go ahead and show it. Stand up, fight back, no time for hoping. Recognize we got that power.
Thank you. wed it. Wake up, let's go, we're on a mission. Recognize we've got that power.
And we make sure that you know it.
Got that pride, go ahead and show it. Stand up, fight back, no time for hoping. Recognize we got that power.
We won't stop until we get it. Come on down, if you wed it. Wake up, let's go, we're on a mission.
Recognize we've got that power.
And we make sure that you know it.
Got that pride, go ahead and show it. Stand up, fight back, no time for hoping. Recognize we got that power. Fight back, no time for hoping. Recognize we got that power.